go back to last season, heading into the Super Bowl, mm-hmm. the number one storyline was Richard Sherman
yeah.
and the post-game interview you did with him after the NFC title game. What was it like to be part of that story? Because you became part of the story.
Mm-hmm. A couple of things. You know, for me, as that whole moment was unfolding, and I've said before, I wasn't worried about what he was saying. I wasn't offended. I wasn't frightened. I'm a huge Richard Sherman fan. I would come home from doing Seattle games and I would tell my boyfriend, I would tell my friends, my family, I love Richard Sherman. If I could come back as a football player, it would be Richard Sherman. I love the intensity he brings. I love how smart he is. People really don't even get that. I think obviously now they do. I was just so worried about what my follow-up question was going to be, because the second he started just losing his mind about that play, which he should have because he saved the game, and it was career-changing for him, I just kept thinking in my head, I can't mess this up. This doesn't happen on television. Nobody gets interviews like this. So I was thinking, oh, God, what's your follow-up
question?
What was
it going to be?
If he wasn't freaking out like that, I knew we'd probably have two questions. Yeah. So I wanted him to go over the play with me. The second question that I had in my head was going to be, we had asked him in our meeting with him the day before. I think Joe had asked him, Joe Buck, have you thought about what going to New York would be like playing in a Super Bowl? And he said, I'm not going to answer that until the game is over. So it was going to
be something
the game
like
is
that.
Over.
Okay.
What do you envision going to New York now? But I couldn't. There was no way I could leave what he was doing. I mean, can you imagine if I had transitioned and he's like, don't you ever talk about me again. Now let's talk about New York. I mean, I would have looked like a fool.
Hey there, I hope you enjoyed this clip from our daily live show, SI Now. You can find a link to the complete episode in the description box below. And while you're there, make sure you subscribe to Sports Illustrated YouTube channel. It's not just SI Now, it's Girls in Bikinis, because we got your back. Remember, you can watch SI Now Monday through Friday live at 1 p.m. Eastern only on SI.com. We hope to see you there with the Girls in Bikinis.